Good morning all. In our last class, we had a discussion about EEG, into which we came to know what is electroencephalogram, what is electroencephalography, and what is electroencephalograph. We studied EEG in terms of its various rhythm, waves, and the association of this waves and rhythm with the state of alertness and wake. Then we saw what is the neural basis for the generation of these waves of electroencephalogram. We studied definition of sleep, which is nothing but temporary and reversible state of unconsciousness from which person can be aroused. Depending on the eyeball movements, sleep is being divided into two different categories: rapid eyeball movement sleep, REM sleep, and non-rapid eyeball movement sleep, that is NREM sleep or slow wave sleep. Of which NREM sleep or slow wave sleep we have discussed in detail. We have studied what are the various autonomic and other changes which will be associated with this particular phase of sleep, consisting of four different stages. And whenever a person falls asleep, he firstly enters into stage 1 of NREM sleep, then he advances through all the four stages of NREM sleep, of which stage 1 and 2 said to be the light sleep and 3 and 4 said to be the deep sleep. Then the person enters into the REM sleep, and this way the sleep cycle, it continues, which is approximately of 90 to 110 minutes. Then we have seen what are the various control mechanisms for the NREM type of sleep. Now it's the time to proceed and to study the second variety of sleep, and that is REM sleep or the paradox. Let us see. After completion of NREM sleep, a new pattern of EEG wave starts suddenly, in which slow waves are replaced by rapid low voltage EEG, as we can see here. There are the four stages of NREM sleep, and then the person is entering into REM sleep, which is characterized by slow waves, which are replaced by rapid low voltage EEG. This is called paradoxical sleep. Why? As the EEG activity is very rapid, like beta rhythm, as seen in awakened state. But still, when the person is in this particular phase of sleep, it is very difficult to awake them, and hence the term must have been given, and that is paradoxical sleep. In fact, threshold for arousal by sensory stimuli raised during this particular stage of sleep. This phase lasts for about 10 to 15 minutes. What are the various features? It is a deeper sleep as compared to NREM sleep, and it is characterized by rapid and growing eye movements, and hence the name is REM type of sleep. Dreams occur and they are remembered as they are getting consolidated. Strong inhibition of spinal motor neuron by the bulbar inhibitory area causes extreme inhibition of muscle tone, and thereby reflexes are lost, and as the tone in the pharyngeal muscles also is decreasing, the snoring may be a very common finding in this particular phase of sleep. Threshold for arousal from sleep is very high. Person is highly irritable. Spontaneous waking occurs in the morning. Heart rate, blood pressure, and respiration are irregular. Exact mechanism is not known, but maybe because of the dreaming that is taking place, or consolidation of dreaming is taking place in this. Next is, there is an occasional occurrence of bruxism. What is bruxism? It is grinding of teeth, which is a common finding in children. Twitches of flaccid muscle and penile erection meningitis. EEG pattern is showing a desynchronized high frequency and low voltage like fast beta rhythm as occurs in alert and wakeful person. If the person is deprived of REM type of sleep for some time and then allowed to sleep, the person is observed to pass more time in the REM type of sleep. Next is phasic potential, which is also called as PGO spike, that is pontogeniculo-occipital spikes. Phasic potential appear in EEG in groups of 3 to 5, as we can see here, the REMC. They originate in the pons and through the lateral geniculate body they are traveling to the occipital cortex, and hence the name has been given, that is pontogeniculo-occipital spike or the PGO spike. Mechanism involved, that is the neural mechanism involved in the paradoxical sleep. EEG pattern resemble to alert and wakeful person. From PET scan in humans, it is observed that neuronal activity is increasing in pons, amygdala and cingulate gyrus during this particular type of sleep. Mechanism that generate REM sleep are located in the pontine reticular formation. REM are triggered by potential originating from pons in the form of pontogeniculo-occipital. Chemical mechanism involved is acetylcholine seems to mediate the REM type of sleep. As in cat, that is the experimental animal, administration of atropine, which is said to be the anticholinergic, suppresses REM type of sleep, whereas injection of physostigmin, which is cholinergic, increases this the duration of REM sleep, and therefore acetylcholine seems to mediate the particular variety of sleep. Decrease in brain monoamine concentration increases REM sleep, whereas reserpine, which decreases or causes depletion of monoamine stores in the body, blocks NREM sleep, but at the same time it increases REM sleep by stimulating activity of PGE. Because it is blocking the NREM sleep, at the same time it is increasing REM sleep, role of monoamines in paradoxical sleep appears to be a problem. Barbiturates, class of drug, it decreases duration of REM sleep. What is the effect of age on sleep? Duration of REM sleep as well as stage 4 of NREM sleep decreases as the age is advanced. As we can see, stage 4 of NREM sleep, and this is REM sleep. Percentage that is spent in stage 4 and REM type of sleep, and year, age in years. Newborns and infants, as we know, sleep 18 to 20 hours a day, of which about 50% is being spent in the REM. What are the various functions of sleep? Sleep is essential for normal functioning of the body, and sleep deprivation results in many dysfunctions. Sleep restores the strength, both physical as well as mental. Ability to think and concentrate is very much enhanced if the person is taking adequate amount of. Sleep consolidates learning and memory. Adequate sleep promotes growth, as during the sleep, growth hormone secretion is. Dreams are produced during the sleep, though utility of dreams depends on ability to remember and to interpret the dream that has been seen. There are various theories of sleep or the sleep-wake cycle. Sleeping or wakefulness is because of the alteration between state of sleep and state of wakefulness of the sleep-wake cycle. Exact mechanism of induction of sleep or to arouse from the sleep is not. Many theories have been suggested, but not a single theory is fully conclusive. Sleep-wake cycle is entrained with the diurnal rhythm in its one of the facts, that is, sleep-wakefulness is synchronized to day-night variation in the environment. And depending on this, there are various proposed theories of sleep-wake cycle, which include role of circadian rhythm, role of pineal gland, thalamocortical loop, and alteration in the neuro. Let us see one by one. Role of circadian rhythm. Any mammalian functions and behaviors are linked to circadian rhythms. Center for this circadian rhythm in humans is suprachiasmatic nucleus, which is located in the head. This particular nucleus is so named as it is located bilaterally above the optic gyrus. As you can see, the optic gyrus and suprachiasmatic nucleus is located above the optic gyrus, and it is located in both the cerebral hemispheres. Suprachiasmatic nucleus is regarded as biological clock, as it has major influence on physiological alteration in diurnal. peaks of circadian activity of suprachiasmatic nucleus correlate with light dark cycle, and sleep wake cycle depends on time of exposure to the bright. How come? Let us see. Exposure to bright light during the day, what it causes? Sleep wake cycle is usually not affected. If the individual is exposed to bright light after evening, onset of sleep will be delayed. And if the individual is exposed to the bright light early in the morning, that will be before the dawn, onset of next sleep period is accelerated. So, exposure to light causes photic stimulation of retina, which causes or which is a very important determinant of sleep wake cycle. Which one? Photic stimulation of retina. And this stimulation occurs whenever the individual is exposed to photic stimulation of retina stimulates the retina hypothalamic pathway that activates or stimulates the suprachiasmatic nucleus and keeps the individual awake by stimulating reticular activity. Then, onset of night, that means the stimulus, that is light, will be removed. That is, there will be loss of photic stimulation of retina. So, inhibition of suprachiasmatic nucleus will take place and there will be onset of sleep because of the inhibition of reticular activity. Second is role of pineal gland. Pineal gland is entrained with the light dark cycle of environment through retina hypothalamic connections of the suprachiasmatic nucleus, and melatonin secretion from this pineal gland, which is controlled by postganglionic sympathetic fibers which innervate the pineal gland. However, secretion of melatonin is said to be more in the evening and in the first half of the night, and it is less in the second half of the night and first half of the day. Let us see the mechanism over here. Photic stimulation of retina, activation of retina hypothalamic fibers, stimulation of suprachiasmatic nucleus, causes activation of sympathetic fibers via superior cervical ganglion, and ultimately there occurs stimulation of pineal gland, which starts releasing melatonin, which controls the rhythm of sleep wake cycle. Melatonin act on reticular activating neurons to mediate the sleep wake. Melatonin acting on melatonin receptor 1, which inhibits the cyclic AMP formation, and by acting on melatonin receptor 2, stimulate formation of IP3 and diacylglycerol. In infants, pineal gland is said to be larger in size. Next is thalamocortical loop. Main elements of this thalamocortical loop is inhibitory reticular neurons. As we can see here, particular loops are running from thalamus to the cortex. These loops generate rhythmic activity of sleep-wake cycle. Thalamic and cortical neurons show typical pattern of rhythmic activity in different phases of sleep-wake cycle. In the waking state, there will be high-frequency rhythmic activity is taking place from thalamic as well as cortical neuron, whereas in the sleep, activity is of low frequency. Next is alteration in the neurochemicals. This is said to be the last theory. Neurons in the brainstem reticular activating system, which are projecting to various areas in the cortex, secrete norepinephrine, serotonin, and acetylcholine. Concentration of norepinephrine and serotonin secreted ultimately modulate the release of acetylcholine and decide the concentration of. And this acetylcholine is said to control the rhythm of sleep and wake cycle. Let us see how. As we can see in this particular flow chart, increased acetylcholine keeps the individual awake and vice versa. That means increased acetylcholine concentration will cause the induction of sleep. As we can see here, inhibition of serotonergic and norepinephrine secreting neurons from brainstem nuclei cause decreased cholinergic neurons or inhibition of the cholinergic neurons in the photine reticular activating system. And decreased concentration of acetylcholine keeps the individual responsible for the waking state of the individual. And reverse will be the case, and hence it is the vice versa situation. Whenever there will be increase in the norepinephrine and serotonin released from the brainstem nuclei, will cause increase in acetylcholine secretion from the pontine reticular activating system neurons, and ultimately will be responsible for induction of this. Role of hypothalamic neurochemicals. Decreased GABA secretion from preoptic nucleus of hypothalamus, this one, and increased histamine secretion from the posterior hypothalamus. together it will be causing increase in the thalamocortical activity, and because of which there will be a state of alert and wakefulness, that is waking. And exactly vice versa will be the situation whenever there will be increase in the GABA and decrease in the histamine release from posterior hypothalamus, that will ultimately inhibit the thalamocortical activity and will be responsible for induction. This table shows us the differences between NREM and REM sleep. Depending on the various changes that we have studied, which occurs during the NREM sleep and REM sleep, we can definitely compare and contrast between the two. That is, NREM sleep, it occurs first, occurs after the NREM sleep. 75% of the total sleep period is NREM sleep, whereas 25% time is spent only in REM sleep. Sympathetic inhibition, sympathetic excitation. There is a no eye movement, and hence the name here, rapid eye movement is taking place, and hence the REM sleep. Dreams are not memorized, so not consolidated. Here, the dreams are consolidated, and therefore, muscle tone is inhibited. It is profoundly inhibited. Types of sleep enters into the deep sleep, as we have seen, stage 1 and 2, light sleep, and 3 and 4 are the deep sleep. Here, the sleep, as REM sleep period is advancing, sleep becomes light and light. EG wave, slow wave, high amplitude. Here, it is high frequency and low voltage. Mechanism, inhibition of reticular activating system. Here, the mechanism is activation of pontine reticular function. What is uses of EEG? The electroencephalogram is used in diagnosis of various type of epilepsies, intracranial space occupying lesion, and diagnosis of sleep. Let us see what is its role, that is the role of EEG in diagnosis of epilepsy. What is epilepsy? It is also called seizure of. It is a disorder of cerebral function which is associated with sudden and uncontrolled discharge of the cerebral neurons. May or may not be associated with loss of. Two main groups of epilepsy, generalized seizure or epilepsy, focal seizures or generalized. As the name is suggesting, generalized seizures with loss of consciousness is associated with generalized synchronous EEG discharge from both the hemisphere, and it is of two varieties, grand mal epilepsy and petit mal. Let us see one by one. Grand mal epilepsy, it is characterized by immediate loss of or sudden loss of consciousness. It is followed by sustained contraction of the limb muscle, which is said to be the tonic phase of grand mal epilepsy. And this tonic phase is followed by jerky movements because of the rhythmic contraction and relaxation of the limb muscle, and this particular phase is said, that is grand mal epilepsy is seen in two phases, tonic phase followed by the chronic. What are the EEG features? In EEG, fast activities are recorded in the tonic phase, as we can see here, and slow activities are recorded in the chronic. Here, as compared to the tonic phase, the frequency is less in the petit mal epilepsy, absence characterized by short-lived loss of consciousness. There is a loss of consciousness, but it is of very brief duration with mild or no motor activity, and therefore the term absence seizure. EEG recording is showing doublets consisting of a spike and a dome. As we can see here, this is a petit mal epilepsy. Here it is a spike followed by a dome. Again, there is a spike followed by a dome. Three such doublets occur typically per second. Focal epilepsy, it is a manifestation which is depending on site of cortex from which the discharges. For example, temporal lobe epilepsy, Jacksonian or motor cortex. Value of EEG to diagnose epilepsy and to confirm the type of epilepsy. And to identify cortical site that may be the focus of abnormal discharge. However, EEG recording between the attacks may be totally or completely. Next is intracranial space occupying lesion. Cerebral tumors do not directly produce abnormal electrical activity, but they in turn compress the adjoining neurons and therefore suppress the activity or normal rhythm of these adjoining neurons, which are being compressed as irregular or slow. This helps in localizing the cerebral tumors. Fluid collection, such as in subdural hematoma, can suppress the neuron and produce local abnormal EEG waves, which are recorded from the underlying cortex. Next is diagnosis of sleep disturbances. Analysis of sleep and diagnosis of sleep disorder or disturbances are accomplished